Mastering proper test tube breathing techniques in the blood bank laboratory is essential. For example, your ability to determine the correct strength of reactivity, identify hemolysis and mixed field reactions, and to discern true agglutination reactions from pseudo-agglutination caused by fibrin, rouleau, or other interferences is crucial to the quality of your patient's test results. This instructional video will demonstrate the basic principles of proper test tube reading techniques. Tubes should always be read with the assistance of the light reader. Turn the light reader on and adjust the direction of the light and the mirror so the light isn't reflecting into your eyes. The reflection of the light will help you read the reactions in the test tubes. Reading test tubes close to the face or above the head is not recommended because of the risk of dropping the tubes and specimen exposure to the eyes or mouth. The best way to view your tubes is using the light reader. When you pull the test tube from the centrifuge, hold the test tube with the open end between your thumb and index finger. Move the tube between the magnifying mirror and the light. Tilt the tube horizontally with a cell button facing up. The supernatant should always be checked for the presence of a pink or red color, which indicates hemolysis, before shaking the test tube. Once cells have dispersed into the solution, hemolysis may be difficult to detect. Gently rock the test tube back and forth so that the supernatant washes across the cell button. Observe the edge of the cell button and look for the presence of a jagged edge or a smooth edge with free floating cells washing off the button. In between rocking, shake the tube gently when the button is in the solution. This gentle shaking motion is sometimes referred to as caffeine jitters. Great care should be taken when shaking the test tubes because shaking too hard can cause reaction strengths to be less than expected or even cause a false negative result. Pay close attention to how the cell button comes off of the tube. Questions you should ask yourself are, did the entire button dissolve into the solution, or did some of the button dissolve and some of it agglutinate? Did the cell button break off in tiny granules and then dissolve into the solution? The presence of one single agglutinate and no free cells is interpreted as a 4+ reaction. The cell buttons in these reactions typically exhibit a jagged or firm edge. A 3+ reaction is characterized by a strong agglutination reaction with a number of large agglutinates and no free cells. Large agglutinates in a sea of smaller clumps of cells with no free cells correlates to a 2+ reaction. The appearance of many small agglutinates and a background of free cells is read as a 1+ reaction. A negative reaction is characterized by the appearance of an even cell suspension with no agglutinates detected. The cell button prior to rocking the test tube will demonstrate a smooth edge, and cells washing off the cell button while rocking the tube will often have a smoky appearance. As an important note, sometimes a very strong agglutination reaction can become stuck to the interior walls of the test tube. Care should be taken not to overshake the test tube in this case, which could break up a 4+ reaction into many smaller clumps and could result in making a falsely weaker interpretation of the original reaction. The presence of a pink or red supernatant is an indication of hemolysis. Care should be taken not to miss noticing in vitro hemolysis because it can be an indication of a very strong antigen-antibody reaction in which complement has been activated and the red cells have been lysed. When in vitro hemolysis is seen, it's important to check that the pretest serum or plasma is not hemolyzed, or if any vials of reagent red blood cells are being used in the test, that they are not hemolyzed. The presence of large, strong agglutinates against a backdrop of free-floating cells is an indication of a mixed field reaction. Such reactions are incredibly important to notice because they are abnormal and the underlying cause should be identified. Fibrin, when shaken out, can appear to be white or light pink, as opposed to the deep red of true agglutination reactions. Care should be taken to properly identify abnormal reactions, pseudo-agglutination, and fibrin interference. Final interpretations should not be made until the cell button has completely detached from the test tube wall. documenting tube reactions should be done concurrently with the reading of the tubes. The quality of patients' results is directly affected by the use of proper tube reading techniques in the blood bank laboratory. By using these techniques, many false positive and false negative reactions can be avoided, and important clues, such as hemolysis and mixed field reactions, can be more easily detected.